you gonna be? The what? The Cowboys? Oh man, I got so many people who Cowboy fans. I gotta do this. I gotta win. I gotta win now. Monday Night Football, man. Let's do this. You know what? I'm going to your town. If we're going to do this, if I'm going to beat you, I'm going to beat you at home. If I beat you. You know what? A little open. It's nighttime. Yo, Raymond. Good game. Marty will shake your hand on this one. Let's see what happens. This is history in the making, man.
Running back brought in to fill in the hole left by Murray 2 years ago in Dallas. It's Ezekiel Elliott going up against DeMarco Murray. So with kickoff straight ahead, we'll check in with our broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Larry, we find ourselves right in the center of the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex in Arlington at AT&T Stadium. Tonight, we've got the crew set for what should be a real treat, a great Monday night matchup between the Dallas Cowboys and the Tennessee Titans. And hi again, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, you take a look at our matchup here. You've got to believe that this is a game that might be won in the trenches.
Oh, without question. This is big person on big person, big unit against big unit.
Meat on meat.
Oh, you got it all. Pick your cliche, but we know this. The ground's going to shake, things are going to rumble, and they're going to have an impact on today's game.
Ryan Succop, the man tasked with getting this one started. And we are underway from AT&T Stadium. This is fielded at the goal line. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. As the Cowboys take the field, they're led out by the AP Offensive Rookie of the Year, and that's Dak Prescott. And while that's a great award, he had a great season. For Cowboy fans, the season ended shy of where they wanted to, but still a lot for them to build on going forward.
And as time goes on, I think those Cowboy fans will reflect on the season. And when you look back at the game that they lost, when they lost to Green Bay in the playoffs, you realize Dak Prescott played really well in that game. So that's got to give them a lot of hope going forward. But I thought the best moment so far in the offseason outside of winning the Super Bowl, Dak Prescott winning the Rookie of the Year Award, and saying Ezekiel Elliott should have half of this award. We should cut it in half because we should share it. That's pretty cool.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I would not want to be an offensive lineman in today's NFL, especially not a center or a guard, if you got to deal with these massive defensive tackles who could not just beat you with strength, but they can beat you with quickness and guile as well. They can get upfield and make plays. And a lot of times what they're taught, just go ahead and tackle everyone that comes in your area and keep the run with the ball.
Eluding the pressure right. And this one caught by Dez Bryant. And they're able to get this one across the 35. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. A glance back at 2016 for Dez Bryant. 50 receptions, under 800 yards, had 8 touchdowns. What do you make of the season that Dez had?
Well, remember, it started with Dez injured, so it took a little while for him to get started. I'm going to make a bold prediction for you. Would not shock me at all if he doubled his catch number next year. Darn near doubled his receiving yardage total. Because if he's healthy all year long, they're going to want to take some pressure off of the run game themselves. And Dak Prescott in his second season should be that much more confident throwing it downfield. And frankly, Brandon, we're talking about things I'm not sure we ever thought we'd talk about in the NFL. And a lot of that is the speed at the linebacker position. A lot of these guys in college, they were safeties. They moved them up to outside linebacker to combat the spread offenses. And now we're seeing it in the NFL, those same guys.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Derek Morgan coming in from that outside linebacker spot to bury him for a loss of 7.
Now, we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight-ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, he really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Daquan Jones in there to drop him, and back-to-back sacks now bring up 4th and long.
Well, there was pressure all around him, so the only play was to try and get out of there. I think it was an excellent effort by him just to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Okay, look at this. The punt team nowhere to be found. They're on the sidelines. Offense going to go for this on the opening drive. Looking to throw. Prescott being chased out left. It's caught.
Oh, you got to be kidding me.
And he'll take it down deep into Tennessee territory.
We know it's tough enough to pick up first downs on third down plays, but when you go for it on fourth down, sometimes you're actually just praying. And on that play, the prayer was answered.
Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And able to surge forward for about 5 yards, down to the 10.
Parker, I know you call the play-by-play, but you know your ball. If I throw these numbers at you, all right, 6 yards shy of 2,000 of total yards from scrimmage for a rookie running back, what do you think?
Sounds like me in high school.
Sounds like you doing it.
Now, it's really fascinating at what he was able to do. The thing for me, though, he did that as a rookie. Where do you go from here? I mean, can you keep going up from those numbers your sophomore campaign?
I think that you can. He's had examples of that preceding him in the NFL. Some guys who are in the Hall of Fame right now. Remember, he had 16 total touchdowns because it's not just his ability to run it. He can catch it out of the backfield as well. No one plays harder than this guy does, down in and down out. I think he's just going to keep getting better.
Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down.
I know in most cases people think you throw the ball in this situation, and when they ran, it almost felt like a little bit of a surrender, maybe a give up, but I don't know if that's really the case.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. That is caught at the 7-yard line. They pass up the 3, fake it. It doesn't work.
I know coaches always tell us that they make decisions about these types of plays, this type of a fake, earlier in the week to take the emotion out of the deal. I don't know that that was really true here. This one felt like all of a sudden, hey, I have a feeling about it. Let's go ahead and get it, and it just didn't work.
Yeah, I know one thing. They wish they had it back.
Yeah, they certainly do, but the buck stops with the head coach on that one. He has to green light that attempt.
Mariota on 1st down. Rishard Matthews here on the catch.
And they'll bring him down here right around the 17-yard line.
Brandon, believe it or not, the first time I saw Rishard Matthews play was a practice session at the University of Nevada in preseason when he was there. And I couldn't take my eyes off of watching him practice because I had not seen that young man before. And I thought, boy, he can be a special player. And I think he's turning into one in Tennessee.
Yeah, and Miami never was really the go-to option. But last year, let's see, 945 yards, 65 catches, 9 touchdowns, all easily career highs.
Began the season really as the number 2 or number 3 receiver in Tennessee. And before halfway through the year, he had become the number 1 option for Marcus Mariota.
A first down throw for Mariota. And this one caught by Delanie Walker. 30, the 20, 10, 5, and he takes it down deep into enemy territory. A big play there on the catch and run. 75 yards.
Coaches really don't care from what position they get this, but run after the catch ability, rack ability, is often the difference between winning and losing and changing field position.
From the 4-yard line, it's first and goal now. And he will take this one in for a Titans touchdown. DeMarco Murray, a 3-yard touchdown run. And the Titans have taken a first quarter lead. And they're able to run it in. It started with a battle in the trenches. They won there, and they got in for 6 points.
And that's going to be a tough one for the defense to deal with. They've got to go to the bench now and figure out how are we going to slow down this running game, because on that particular play, they had no answer.
And this is good. Our score, 7-0, Tennessee. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. We focus our attention on the Titans defense now. And out now come the Cowboys. And on the last drive, they were in field goal range. They just opted not to kick it, didn't get it. How does that change the mentality this go around?
I don't think it changes much for the head coach, because this is what he preaches all the time. Attack at all times in any spot on the field. And he likes touchdowns, not field goals. Now, your field goal kicker, you got to make sure you nurse him through and say, okay, don't worry about it. When we need you, you've got to be ready to go. And the team, of course, loves to see points on the board. So let's see if it changes a little bit. They're in the same spot again.
Yeah, we'll see what the decision is here if they get to that spot. It's already 2nd and 12. The defense hoping to push them back more. They come up in an offset eye. They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
2 plays in a row, the defense won, stacking up the running game. They've got to feel good about themselves, but something has to be in the back of their minds. Are we being set up for something big? They've got to be careful.
And they'll add a DB in the secondary here on 3rd and 14. And he's going to lose yardage here back to the 12-yard line. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's 4th down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
And how about this? 4th and long, and they're going to go for it. They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott dancing to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And that's caught inside the 30. An unbelievable play there on 4th and long. 68 yards.
And they pick up the 1st down on a 4th down play. I don't know if the defense relaxed because they thought maybe they'd stopped him on 3rd down, or if they just didn't protect the sticks very well. But boy, that's a big time pickup right there.
Red zone opportunity. Sitting alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, as it is Cowboy football to begin quarter number 2. And they're on the move here. They've got it 1st and 10.
A first down throw for Prescott. Escaping the pressure right. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Avery Williamson leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six.
It's interesting, partner, that most defenses try and guard the 35-yard line actively because they think the way kickers are nowadays, about a 52-yard field goal, they're kind of giving up points. But you get even deeper into territory, you get into the red zone, they're going to guard it even more, which means more pressure, more blitzing.
Steps away to his left. And on the left side, he's got Witten. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end like that.
Here's Prescott. Flush to his right. And that is incomplete. Gavin Escobar, his big tight end, was the intended receiver. And now it's fourth down.
I know we're doing this game live, but let's step into the film room for just a second, because when they review this play, oh, the negatives are going to be incredible on this one.
And the holder's going to keep it. He's going to try to run for it. They pass up the three, fake it. It doesn't work. But clearly that was a design play. I just don't know that it was the right design. Hey, your holder to have him pick it up and kind of be the power guy trying to run through the middle. Everything has to go right for that to work.
You mean you weren't relying on just great blocking to get him through? You kind of think maybe he can help make his own way if he's an actual running back instead of the holder? Yeah, I thought the same thing.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. And a nice carry there of 15 yards.
It may sound trite to a lot of people, but when you have a team that actually does believe in you, it really helped your overall play. DeMarco Murray found exactly that in Tennessee with the Titans.
Because he didn't really have him. You're alluding to him not having that in Philadelphia.
Yeah, without a doubt. I mean, look, he started as the guy there. By the end of the season, he was no longer that guy. The offense didn't seem to fit for him, but it fit perfectly in Tennessee as he led a big-time attack, third in the league in rushing.
Yeah, finishing just shy of 1,300 yards, 12 total touchdowns as well.
Mariota now from the 50. He's going to get this one out to his fullback. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage, even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
They'll come out in the pistol. On third down, Mariota. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Putting pressure on the guy throwing the football is always good, but when you can couple that with contact on him that leads to an incompletion, as we just saw there, that's winning football.
Much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out. So.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Wesley Woodyard. He's the one that got to him. He takes him down for a loss of nine.
Man, he got in there so quickly, Charles. What could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure coming at you, and you change the blocking schemes. Maybe you go to max protection. The biggest...
Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jason McCourty, and they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line.
Maybe he telegraphed it a little bit right there. You've got a cornerback knowing that he's going against a rookie quarterback. He stepped in and picked it.
You think he had a great week of preparation, looking forward to this opportunity? And the second part of that is, when you're a young quarterback, you are going to stare down targets, but oftentimes your playbook hasn't expanded to give you
full field reads as well. Makes it a little bit tougher for him.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Again, it's Murray. And give him about 5 as he gets this up to the 48-yard line. Brandon Carr there to make the stop.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that anytime you hand the ball to a back.
Offense coming up, needing 2 yards on third down. They come up in an offset eye. Here's Mariota. And he locates Walker, complete. And he will have a first down here at about the 40.
And Brandon, from our time in college football, where receivers weren't running the traditional NFL route tree, one thing they did learn, find open areas, find soft spots, and set up and catch the ball. And I think we just saw that there.
Yeah, we saw that indeed, picking up the first. On first down, Murray. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Mariota now on second down. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. Third and long here for Mariota. Flushed out right. Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's 4.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. Are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. Now Dallas gets set to take the field.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football.
In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. Brian Arakpo in there to get him, the 6th time they've sacked him tonight.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
And the 2-minute warning lurking. This will probably be the last play before we hit it.
Yeah, they want to get themselves in position to score in this last shot before the clock hits.
2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. A reminder that when halftime rolls around, Larry Ridley will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. And some changes here as the D-line separates some. Here's Prescott. And now he'll turn, and off his back foot, he'll heave this deep. No, he almost had it. Already with 1 interception, just missing his 2nd there.
The name of the game is always on defense, put pressure on the quarterback. And that's exactly what they've done today. It looks like they've got him a little bit rattled. That would have been the 2nd interception in the first half.
On the run, Dunbar. And not much there at all as he'll get this only up to about the 11. Just a 2-yard pickup, and that should necessitate a call for the punt team here on 4th down.
But once again, a good example of situational football. That was 3rd and very long, so you know they were guarding against the pass. And when they decided to run the ball, that was okay. Whatever yardage they picked up, as long as they didn't get to the first down marker, The defense was willing to concede, and they stopped him well short of a first down.
They'll break the huddle here and go for it. This is fourth down. They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. He's going to run, but he's got a long way to go. A big play there on the scramble. 32 yards.
Now, those are the ones that hurt defensively. You do everything right. Excellent pressure, good coverage downfield, and then he slips out the back door and turns it into a nice gain.
On first and 10, Prescott. He finds his target, Terrence Williams. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
On some of these plays, you know what they're really a product of? Really good scouting. Big, tall receiver. Play to his strengths. Put the ball up there and let him take it on a fade.
So this brings up a second and 2. They come out with one back and 3 tight ends. Out to his left. He shakes him off. He can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
Escobar with it over the middle. Touchdown, Cowboys! Gavin Escobar as the first half is winding down. And the Cowboys are an extra point away from tying the football game. And a little time left on the clock, so on the other side, they're thinking, gosh, we'd like to get that lead right back.
Yeah, thanks for pointing that out. Here I am going ahead and tapping out the first half.
Well,
there's still time.
Way.
They've got to make a decision about what they want to do on the kickoff, whether they want to let their return guy touch it.
Dan Bailey now for the extra point. And it's no good. He misses the extra point, and this remains a 7-6 game. Bailey now to kick it away and the touchdown. To return, this is Mark Mariani. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. They'll put 2 receivers left, 2 to the right. Mariota on first down. He's going to let this one go deep. And that is incomplete. 2 seconds left on the clock.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
Final play of the half here, Mariota. And this one is incomplete. So we're at halftime with our score 7-6 in a tough-fought first half. As we send you on over to Orlando, where we'll check in with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. Both the Titans and the Cowboys are having some issues finding a way into the end zone. They'll both look to improve their play on offense.
Okay, so Larry apparently giving us the silent treatment all of a sudden, and we're going to skip ahead to quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Antonio Andrews now to return. He juked him. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
See if they do just that. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets them to 2nd and 4.
I know the toss play begins with the guy taking the snap and turning around and tossing it to the runner. But where the real intrigue is, can they seal the edge? Whether it's an offensive tackle or a tight end in the direction they want to run the football. If they do that, that's the result that you get, that type of a gain. If they don't, oftentimes it's not a very successful play. Partner, I think the easy thing now would be to just abandon the run and start throwing the football at all costs. But I've been in so many games where it doesn't work running the ball, doesn't work running the ball, and then something pops, and now you've got something going. I'm not so sure to just abandon your game plan this early in the second half.
On third down, Mariota rolling to his left. He may try and run for this. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
Now that definitely hurts because the mindset is getting a three and out there and they don't get it done. They give up the scramble and a pickup for a first down.
Fresh set of downs here. Mariota now to throw on first down. And he's going to drop this off to his fullback. Give him 8 on the play and it'll make it second down.
It's interesting because when I'm watching college football and I'm evaluating guys for the draft now, my list of fullbacks, pure fullbacks, it's a very short list. I'm probably evaluating more punters and kickers now than I am fullbacks. But does it matter what you call the position? It's who you put there, and there we saw completion.
And 5 yards on the play there as the drive will continue.
But we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. A lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
He's got a man. It's his fullback. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 5 yards on the pickup, and it'll bring up a second down.
Now, that's often a surprise for the defensive guys when they see the big fella slide out of the backfield and catch the ball. Not something they usually go over in practice very often.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. They'll give him 1 yard on the play, and that's going to bring up a third down.
All right, I'm going to show my age here a little bit. We used to talk about running backs catching the ball as safety valves. Nowadays, they're a big part of the passing offense.
Quit acting like you're so old. You're only 65.
Here's the former Heisman winner. It's Derrick Henry. And he'll take this one down to about the 40. Call it a 4-yard pickup, but it leaves him a few inches short here on fourth down. Too long for a field goal, too short to punt. That in-between range, and they'll go for it on fourth down. They'll sneak it with Mariota. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches.
And this is a spot where you have your offense stay out there to get those few inches. It's too long for a field goal. It's not worth punting, so this is the right decision. Concern, and they wind up picking up the first down.
They come out with one back and three tight ends. A run, it's Murray. And they're able to get this one past the 30 down to the 25. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. DeMarco Murray, his second touchdown of the night. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead.
And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And last year that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year he's not where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to...
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Wesley Woodyard in there to drop it for his second sack now here tonight.
Partner, the Mike linebacker, the middle linebacker, has so many different responsibilities. How excited do you think he was to get home with that blitz?
Yeah, he wants a sack. He got it. They come out with one back and three tight ends. Buying time to his left. And Escobar has it left side. A good pickup there, 18 yards as they get closer for third down.
I think that should have been chalked up as a winning play for the defense, and they somehow beat it, didn't they? Right-handed quarterback flush to his left, yet he finds his tight end on the left side of the field. That's a tough throw. What a great completion.
Now Prescott. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. Now the offense is not leaving the field. They're going to stay out and go for it on fourth and three. They're indeed going for it. It's Prescott. Complete to Jason Witten. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. I don't know if I agree with that. I guess they don't care if I agree with that. But, boy, you have to be surprised by that, right?
I definitely was surprised that they decided to go for it in this situation. But they must have either felt like they either had a great play call on or they're trying to show extreme confidence.
First down, Prescott. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
The man with over 1,000 catches, Jason Witten, the intended receiver. And it's third down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he sensed being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Parrish Cox. And he's able to bring it up 5 yards shy of midfield to the 45-yard line. That had disaster written all over. You've got a right-handed quarterback rolling left and throwing it pretty far downfield.
It's really difficult to do, to try and get your body twisted around into the proper position and get anything on the ball as you heave it downfield. And that's what it actually turns into, a heave. And that's not really a good throw, is it?
Not good, and we saw the result. Throw it, and they get to Mariota here as he's dropped on the sack. They'll wind up losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down.
Oh, my goodness. Was that a defensive back that got to him with the pressure?
Oh, look at the former defensive back. You're all smiles up here.
I hope everybody can hear my smile on that play.
One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Arlington. It's the Titans. They've got the football. They'll be looking to extend their lead here as we begin the fourth quarter. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Second down, Mariota. Forced out to his left. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Tajay Sharp, the intended target. And it's third down.
Really nice play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball, but for the guys on the offensive line, they're doing a nice job of trying to protect their passer. But when a guy hops in the air and goes airborne to try and knock one away, it's difficult because you can't reach out and grab him. That'll be a holding penalty. So all you're trying to do is make some type of a play on him, make some type of contact to try and get his arms out of the sky.
Third and long here for Mariota. And Matthews over the middle with a grab. They'll wind up with 17 on that one, but they're still a bit short here for fourth.
Boy, they had a lot of real estate to make up there, but what a big-time play for them. Nice completion, excellent game. Now they're in fourth and manageable.
Just a little short, though, with that marker. The offense here not budging. They're going to fight for it on fourth and inches. Mariota to sneak it. It'll be a pickup of just two, and they're able to convert here on fourth and inches.
I like the reasoning. It's too far for a field goal, and it's too short to really get a big field position edge on a punt. Let's go for it. And sure enough, it's the ground game that's able to convert for them on fourth down.
They keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. And this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. Six, seven, eight, nine, whatever it's going to take. Puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Call it a gain of five there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
They'll run here. It's Murray. DeMarco Murray, kiss him goodbye. Touchdown, Titans. DeMarco Murray, 35 yards. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. He keeps carrying the ball into the end zone, and in this one, he's sort of carrying the team on his back.
He's the reason that they lead right now, no question about it. And you talk about on his back, he's not minding the extra weight at all, is he? Carrying that just as lightly as he does the football. Yeah, what a great performance so far.
Those three touchdowns, it's got him in the lead.
All right, partner, one more time. Our whole lives, you put the ball on the three-yard line, kick the extra point. 2015, they put it on the 15 to kick the extra point. 2016, they said, we're leaving it there. So if you want to fake it, that's a long way to go. And they got it done.
I was going to say, they had a 15-yard play in their back pocket.
You don't see that on too many play sheets, do you?
No. What a spin. And he'll be taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. And now the Titans defense gets set to go again. And the interception the last time, their third takeaway of the game, Charles.
They're just flocking to the football so well. And not only are they doing that, they're making big-time plays and taking it away from them. Big hits, big plays. They're looking very good in this ball game.
You said flocking, flying to the football. Coaches always use that, don't they?
They really do. It's almost as it goes back to the old, when they click off the frame at the end of a play, they want to see all 11 defensive guys in that picture. It's got to the point where we see guys like that make that type of a catch. Not fair goes through my brain. That size, that speed, and now they're acting like wide receivers,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, tight end one-handed catches. They're kind of like wide receiver one-handed catches nowadays.
Just not right.
One man in the backfield, Elliott. Now Prescott being chased out left. And on the left side, he's got Witten. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. A gain of six there on first.
Looked like the screen pass was taken away there, and that was a nice job of improvising, but it's not normal. Usually when the screen pass is taken away, you're taught to just throw the ball at the ground at the feet of the receiver so that you don't get it intercepted and just start over. But he ended up finding another receiver.
Prescott now on second down.
And for a third time tonight, through an opening, and there he goes. Picked off by Wesley Woodyard. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Short throw, pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
I had to do it, Sam.
And that PAT pushes the lead up to 23.
I had to
now.
Come to the Dallas Cowboys.
Of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another
I had to come to the Dallas Cowboys Stadium.
And now the kick is away. Now it's Lucky Whitehead on the return. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. So out come the Cowboys now as their offense gets set to take over. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Avery Williamson in there to get him again. The third time he sacked him here tonight.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big. But sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz. And even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there. They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on, catching the ball and not much run after the catch. A nickel set shown by the Titans on third down.
Thinking pass. Dancing to his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by the safety, Rashad Johnson. And a return across midfield and to the 46-yard line.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Well, here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looks pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. And on second and 10 now. A play fake to Murray. Now Mariota. Walker with a grab, left side. A good pick up there at 22.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Mariota now to throw on first down. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Terrell McClain in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10. And they weren't in zone coverage. They were in man, and each man did his job.
And that looked like vintage, old-school coverage, didn't it? Man coverage reminded me of an old Raiders team. They had a Hall of Famer at one corner and a Defensive Player of the Year at the other, and they just locked people down.
They'll need to get the playoff quickly. Now a second down throw for Mariota. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off, down the numbers. There he goes. Past the 20. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown.
So a pick six there out of the nickel package. They went with five DBs.
Almost becoming the base package in the NFL is the nickel. Hard to throw against. That was demonstrated one more time. A pick six going the other way.
Here we go. Cut.
They'll try and throw for it. This will be caught at about the five. And they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful.
I know they didn't tack on the 2 points, but I liked their attempt. After the interception return for a touchdown, I was thinking to myself, forget kicking it, go for two, and they did.
Well, yeah, and everybody's scrambling. Maybe you catch the defense on their heels. They weren't ready to be out there.
Yeah, it's almost like a sudden change, right? There's a turnover, you take it away. They stuck it in the end zone. Keep the momentum going. Give credit to the defensive guys for rallying and stopping that two-point attempt.
Here's the Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position, not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And they're going to speed things up here. They go with Murray again. And not much there. Maybe a yard up to the 24. Sean Lee, the Pro Bowler, there for the tackle. On third down, Mariota. And he hits his man, Matthews. And he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10. A first down throw for Mariota. He's going to look deep down the field. Oh. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays, and you don't get many opportunities to dial them up, and they just did, and they drop it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt.
That was second down run for Murray. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on that one as it brings up a third and 10.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one, but he's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Henry. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down.
One of the things I love about this game is as a match of wits throughout the game. Who's going to get the advantage? Who's going to catch someone off guard? I feel like the offense thought they might catch the defense off balance with that play call, but unfortunately, that didn't work for them.
The Titans go. It's Mariota. He's going to air it out deep for Matthews. And that's caught inside the 30. And they do finally get him, but he takes it to the 25.
And they just hit another big completion there. And I think in days gone by in the NFL, you might have asked, is this a little bit of overkill? Is this rubbing it in? I don't think people feel the same way nowadays.
It's the age-old argument. Then you could say on the other side, if you're going to get angry about it, stop it, right?
Go ahead and stop me. And I think a lot of the times they just look at it like, let's just play the game. And how it turns out, it turns out.
Kyle Wilbur there to make the stop.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
All Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add three more, a little insult to injury here late in the game. From the right hash, it's a 41-yard attempt. And they're going to take it all the way down and just take the delay.
Delay of game, offense. Still second down.
Oh, now look at this. They're lining up to add three more, a little insult to injury here late in the game. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through, and that will extend their lead even further. Well, partner, even though my phone alarm failed me this morning and I missed our AM workout, we still made it through this thing together, didn't we?
Well, you always know I need extra workouts just to keep up with you, so it doesn't matter.
That was a beautiful game. I had to go into the Arlington Stadium and come out victorious. If you are a Dallas Cowboys fan, you hate to watch this video. But if you are a Titans fan, you love to see this video. Hey, man, hit the subscribe button. You might get something in the mail that's rewarding, maybe like a 10-pound gold nugget. But if you don't, hit a like. Put a dislike. Leave a comment below. Do whatever you feel. As for me, I'm taking all Cowboys' hearts away. This has been the new legal representing Direct Gaming. And until next time, guys, hey, yo, peace.